All right, so today we're going to learn how to transform a blurry illustration into a more sharp illustration and add some really important edges, some key edges on our illustration. And I'm going to show you a few tricks to do those. Hi guys, today I want to show you a little bit about art edges and suff edges and how to play with them to make sure that you have some really nice illustrations. I see a problem sometimes on the painting that I see from my student, and the problem is they're missing a little bit of sharpness. They're missing some edges in their painting, and I just want to demonstrate that on a painting that I'm painting right now. Right now you can see on the left side, that's my painting where I am right now. It's not done, but that's where I am right now. You see that there's a little bit more a sharpness to it, and here I softened up the whole thing just to show my point today. And basically, what's it's missing on the right is all those small art edges that will help your eye to actually read the illustration. And those edges are really important. That's the harmony of your painting. That's where you're going to read it. That's how your eye is going to move on the painting. If you have, like you have on the right, something too soft, then, well, I'm dry to the eye right away, which is, it's a good point because it's a portrait right now. So to be drawn to the eye is good. But I'm missing so much information that the rest is boring. I want to have those little imperfections, those little edges everywhere that just show the form of the face as much as just little details of the illustration. And to do so, I'm just going to use two tools. I'm going to use the suffern brush, and I'm going to use the art edge brush, and I'm going to mix those two between the eraser and the brush. So right now I had like on the brush, if I switch the eraser, then I'll be able to actually get art edges and soft edges at the same time. And the opposite is valid as well. So using those two tools only, we're gonna bring back those edges on this illustration. Okay, so here, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new layer, and I just wanna show you. So the details that I wanna bring back, the edges that I wanna bring back, depend on your subject. Now, when it comes to a portrait, the way to know where to put them is easy. You just have to imagine your whole subject in geometric shapes. So let's say here I got the nose, I would do this. And I got the eye like this. And then I got the eyebrow like this. And I know that here I'm gonna have the brow ridge. Makes the connection with the nose and the bone structure here. And all these can be drawn as art edges. Now, I don't have to do all of them. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna choose the one that I want. So I'm going to create a new layer first, and like I said, I'm going to use, for starters, only the soft edge and the art edge brush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create here the fold under the eye here. So I'm on a new layer, and I'm just going to take some brown here, and I'm going to paint with my soft brush under it here. And right now what I'm doing with my soft brush, you see that I don't care about this part. It's only the part that's here that I care about, because now I'm going to take my art edge eraser and I'm going to go carve the shape that I want. Just like that. And it's going to bring back that art edge that I was missing. Now, right now it's pretty rough. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the suffern brush as an eraser now, and I'm just going to erase a few parts. And that way, I've been able to just bring back that edge. I'm going to do that the same thing for the eyebrow here. So for the eyebrow, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the art edge brush, and I'm going to try to carve a art edge here. And I'm going to create a new layer, and what I'm going to do here is see, I'm going to paint. And just like that, I have a art edge brush. But what it did here is I can really see the strokes here, and that's not really what I want. So I got a better trick for that. I'm going to delete this here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the lasso tool. So I'm going to use the lasso tool. You can find the lasso tool right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just draw the line that I want and make a bubble like this. And I'm going to use the soft round brush and I'm going to paint on this like that. And I'm going to deselect. And now you can see I've been able to actually have that hard edge that I wanted to, but I don't have the stroke that I created with the soft round brush, because the soft round brush will give me a gradient each time. So now I brought back those two things. I'll do the same thing for the nose here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use again the lasso tool, and I'm just going to paint. I'm going to trace the contour of the nose. I'm going to use the saffron brush. I'm going to pick up the color here to finish the edge. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to invert this one. So right now you can see that I'm not painting outside of it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to invert it. I'm going to do Command Shift I, and you didn't see anything changing, but now you see I can paint only on the opposite side. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick the color of the nose here, and I'm just going to paint like this, the outside. And when I'm going to deselect, you see that it brought me back a really hard edge now, which is perfect. I'll do the same thing for the nostril. I'm going to take this here and just draw the nostril like this. I'm going to take a dark color, fit it in. I'm going to go outside. Actually, I'm going to deselect for this one. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to paint. I'm going to take the skin here with the soft round brush, and I'm just going to come and paint just a little bit like this, mixing the brushes. And that way it's going to bring me that softness with mixed with the hard edge to bring back that nostril. Now you can see that my lines would still need some work, but I've been able to start from something that was totally blurry to bring back just those edges that will help me read my illustration. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you find that helpful. If you like what you see, feel free to like, share, or comment below this video. I will also add another link, this link, for you to watch. It's a video that I've been doing on four different ways to render that could absolutely help you when you render your next portrait. And till then, happy painting!